What's good, y'all? It's your guy Bendu. So I wanted to cover further how you know, everybody's favorite progressive hero Bernie Sanders is still blowing establishment bullshit up your ass. So this is from I originally saw this on Secular Talk, but this is from Jeff Stein, and he had this scoop. So he says the White House budget will not include key Biden campaign pledges such as the public option, prescription drugs reform. One second, sorry about that. Prescription drug reform or student debt relief, per sources. White House squarely focused on $4 trillion in jobs and infrastructure plus family plans. The Biden administration had begun work to incorporate campaign proposals for the budget. White House decided budget will instead be a narrow reflection of what has already been proposed. Jobs plan, families plan, discretionary spending increases. The president's budget will focus on advancing the historic legislative agenda he's already put forward for this year. The budget won't propose other new initiatives. Of course, as my guy Nick is a Fred Hampton leftist, he said Joe Biden is to the right of the average Republican voter on health care and criminal justice. So again, as you know, and not surprising, Joe Biden is backing out of his campaign promises. Another, you know, as DJ Khaled would say, another one. But what's even worse is that everybody's favorite progressive hero, Bernie Sanders, came out cucking for him again. So this is from Jeff Stein. Again, Bernie Sanders puts out a statement saying he is delighted prescription drug reform and Medicare at 60 are in the White House budget. This appears to be incorrect. The White House calls in general terms for these policies, but they are not reflected in the budget itself. So again, this is Bernie Sanders blowing more establishment smoke up your ass. This is Bernie Sanders, you know, this is the same as Bernie Sanders. This is why Bernie Sanders is the biggest letdown that you can ever think of, you know, and it sucks to say this. It really does, because I know a lot of people fucked with him. I wasn't the biggest, you know, fan of his. I only liked him because he was behind the policies that I liked. But it was always something that I felt, I'm like, what? He's lacking something. And balls and courage is honestly what it was. That's why I was such, you know, a Tulsi supporter. You know, I was such a huge fan of Tulsi because she was not afraid to speak her mind whenever, you know, on what it was. And she was the most shitted on candidate, you know, during the whole election cycle and everything. And you know, they Russiagated her. They called her everything in the book, man. A Putin, a willful idiot. I think that's what Hillary called her. So, yeah. But again, this just shows you that Bernie Sanders is always going to bend the knee to the establishment, because Bernie Sanders doesn't want to go down in history as the most hated man in politics, because that's what he doesn't want to be. Jeremy Corbyn. He doesn't want to be Ralph Nader, because those are the things that happens when you actually stand up for the people. They destroy you. And they defame you. So, and that's, you know, that, and that's not just for Bernie Sanders. You know, everybody's sitting here, you know, getting all excited. Oh my God, Nina Turner's about to get in office. She's going to get in office and do the same fucking thing AOC is doing, do the same thing Ilhan Omar is doing, do the same thing Rashida Tlaib, Ayanna Pressley, Cori Bush, Jamal Bowman's bitch ass. Yeah, you already know I always got to refer to him with, you know, bitch ass after I say his name, because that's exactly what he is. He's a Barack Obama 2.0. You know, all of them, man. She's going to get in there and bend the knee just the same as the rest of them have. And that's just what it is, man, because they're politicians at the end of the day. So my faith isn't in politicians anymore. My faith isn't in electoral politics anymore. My faith is in people, honestly. You know, recently had a conversation with a friend that, you know, I couldn't help but agree with him. He has a very pessimistic take, but shout out, you know who you are, bro. But we were having a conversation, and one of the things he told me was that he feels that, you know, we lost back in the 70s, man. You know, the country's going to shit. Chris Hedges talks about that a lot. You know, the great American dream is over. And, I agree. I definitely agree. But in my opinion, this is the time where the people need to rise up and forge, you know, something better than America. You know, when ideas and symbols, you know, fail you, you don't try to uplift, you know, those same ideas and failures, in my opinion. You forge new ones. You forge better ones. And, that's how I feel. I feel like, you know, America was forged on bullshit, faulty foundations, man. It was forged on lies. It was forged on slavery, genocide, racism, you know, all of that, all of it. And it's like colonialism, imperialism. It was, you know, that's what this country was birthed, you know, birthed out of. So you can't be surprised when this country continues to do what it's been doing since its inception and since before it was even, you know, a fucking country to begin with. So in my opinion, you know, I definitely I wasn't saying that to say that I disagreed. And what I'm saying is this is the perfect time for us to step up and forge something new. You know, Professor Wolf talks about this a lot when it comes to capitalism versus socialism and how socialism, you know, is the replacement for capitalism to eventually lead to communism is what he says a lot. And look, that's a lot of isms. I don't know about all that shit. I just know, you know, shit needs to change. You know, we're seeing the great, you know, the great shift in the financial sector with currency going fully digital, you know, that we don't, that we're not going to see ever again. And that's something that is very important. And that's why you have people like Elon Musk. And I know I'm on a completely different subject now, but this is the reason why people like Elon Musk, you know, are fucking with, you know, getting funny with the cryptocurrencies. This is why you hear people like Warren Buffett shitting on cryptos and Bill Maher's bitch ass. I'm going to be dropping a video about that on Friday. Look out for that. But, you know, this, we do have our opportunity, but unfortunately I feel like we have too many, what's the word I'm looking for? It's too many people trying to play it nice still. You feel me? They still believe in the electoral politics system, but they don't realize that shit is bought. And, you know, there was this thought process I was having. Like, look at how China has, you know, basically has basically put the United States in a constant, you know, state of check. Honestly, like, there's literally, outside of, you know, war, going to war of China, which is going to be the end of the world because that's going to be nuclear war, there's nothing they can do to stop the rise of China and the inevitable you know, takeover of them as the superpower in the world. There's nothing they can do, and this was all based off of China using capitalism against them. And I'm not sitting here trying to preach what a lot of these rappers preach, like, oh, we need to make more money. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is we need to study what China did and find some way to make that, you know, to extrapolate that process here and use it for us. Because there's something there. Like, this is kind of like a ramble and a rant as well, but I've been having a lot of ideas about that. I feel like, you know, and I want to sit down with some people and cultivate that idea. Because, like, you know, everybody likes to run around and just shit on capitalism. And I'm with it. I'm 100% with you. But it's like, how can we use capitalism against our enemy? How can we use, you know, our enemy's kryptonite against them? Our enemy, you know, takes their kryptonite and make it their strength. But China has figured out a way to take that kryptonite and actually make it the weakness that it's actually supposed to be. And it's worked, honestly, so far. And I know a lot of you don't fuck with the whole China thing and everything, but I don't know. That's just a thought I was having. So I'm going to go ahead and stop rambling, close the video out there. As always, guys, thank you for tuning in. Like, comment, subscribe, and share, because y'all know YouTube is trying to keep us down, down, down. So definitely like, comment, subscribe, and share. Emphasis on all that. Same thing on Odyssey. Keep showing love out there, y'all. And yeah, thanks for tuning in. Peace. We'll be right back.